Well, Danny, I think if there was a competition to find the happiest man in Spain right now, like the race, you'd probably win it. Always special to win in MotoGP, Danny, but it's that extra special feeling to win in front of your home crowd here in Jerez. You had to work very, very hard for it, but you must be on top of the world.
Yes, it's true. I, like you say, I'm on top of the world now because so amazing this feeling, and had a super weekend, very good feeling on the bike in this amazing track that I like so much, and with also these fans. Just enjoy it very, very much. To be conscious of this moment is super important, because when you are young, normally you get to these things very unconscious. Like, you don't know why it's happening really, but it's happening. But as you get older, you have to be conscious, and you have to make it happen by yourself. So that's why it's much more emotional now. And the team works so well. We are getting a bit better race by race. Had quite a good race last one, podium, and then come here and win. So it's just amazing, and we want to continue in this line.
You ran a different tyre combination to Mark. The difference between the two of you is that you ran that medium option rear tyre. What do you think was the key to your victory today?
Yes, it's true. The track condition was not as good today as in the practice. The pace was slower. I had to pick the hard front. My favorite was, I would say, the medium. I could be faster in the medium, but for the track conditions, I had to go on the hard. I kept the medium rear, so I pull a gap in the beginning, quite quick, and then I said, okay, I need to stop going so fast, because I must manage the rear tire. And yeah, when Mark get the second position, he start pushing, you know, but the front was so critical. You can lose the front very easy and in these track conditions, and it was difficult to go faster, but really, really happy to give this win to the team and to manage the race, because at one point the gap was there with Mark, but amazing to be able to do this kind of race.
What's that like when you're doing lap after lap and you see 93 plus one every lap?
Yeah, it's true. You know, Mark will push to the end, and he's a guy that never give up. So you must have this in mind. And I was prepared for that already. Yesterday we had our little battle, similar battle like today in the qualifying, and put some good show there. But today was really determined to stay in the gap.
Next up, Danny, the French Grand Prix in Le Mans. What are your thoughts on Le Mans and in terms of the championship now as well? The top four riders covered by just 10 points. It's going to be pretty hot, the competition now, for the rest of the season.
Yes, it's true. Happy today, because we were able to do a good weekend, good race, and our rivals not as strong as in the past races. Strange though, because normally they are favorites in this track. I don't know really what happened, but happy to pull back some points because of our mistake in Argentina. So now we are closer, and this is positive. Now, after the last podium and this win, we hope to continue with this line, and that the bike works well also in Le Mans.
Just finally, Danny, before we let you go and kick off the celebrations tonight, it was a milestone weekend here for Grand Prix racing. Angel Nieto won the 1,000th Grand Prix. Mick Doohan won the 2,000th Grand Prix. Today was your first win in Spain since 2013. You picked the perfect time to do it, because today was the 3,000th Grand Prix. I guess that makes it that a little bit extra special, Danny.
Yes, it's true. I'm a very lucky guy to be the 3,000th race winner of the championship, because to be along names with like Mike Doohan and Angel Nieto is super. So really excited and very, very, very happy.
Yeah, we hope to see you as strong again in race number 3001 in 2 weeks' time, Danny.
Thank you.
Thank you.